Okay, so I'm going to carry on now with Gork. You'll see if you remember that I had to keep the bin util source and build directory, so they're both there still. Let's move on to Gork. So a lot of these packages in this part share a very similar procedure for configuration, building, even testing and installing. So I'm just going to bolt these all together, run them all at once, and reuse this command to save copying and pasting. Just make the process a bit smoother. And these packages all tend to take sort of several minutes on this machine. So it can be quite intensive, as in you've got to sit there and wait for it to finish just after a few minutes. It's not a quick thing where you're typing continually because the machine's quick enough and it's not too slow that you can leave it for 20 minutes, half an hour for all these short ones. 4 minutes was about right, considering that an SPU on this machine was about 20 minutes, if I remember correctly. So we're probably looking at similar times, as I several minutes for each of these little packages. So I move on to core utils. So once again, I'm going to recall that command. And looks like it's going to be about 20 minutes. So this one's just under an SPU. Okay, let's call utils complete. Let's tidy up and move on to bzip 2. So this is one command for this, by the looks of it. That's done. So now we go on to gzip. And once again, I'll recall that command and wait a minute or two for this to complete. And that's done. Tidy that up and move on to diff utils. And as you can see, the commands are the same for most of these packages now. Okay, that's done. Go to find utils. And once again, we can use the same set of commands. Okay, that's done. Move on to make. And once again, we can reuse our string of commands to build this package. Okay, that's done. And let's tidy that up and move on to grep. So we've got a slightly different configuration this time, so I'll have to copy that in. Let's build it. Okay, and we can finally install it. And tidy up. So move on to sed. And once again, we can recall that sequence of commands to build sed. Okay, that's said done. So let's tidy that up and move on to get text. Okay, so once again, we can use the same set of commands. And I'm not sure how this long is going to take. It says 7 SBUs, but it does say the test takes a while, so that'd be equivalent of probably about 2 hours. So I can't imagine get text will take that long. Just compiling it, it's got to include the tests. Okay, so that's all built. Let's tidy that up and move on to end curses. So the first thing we've got is a couple of patches. They're okay, we've got a configure here with some extra options. Okay, let's now build that. Okay, the site's finished, so I'll just install it now. Okay, that's done. So now move on to patch. And we've got a slightly different configure command here. Does actually say that you can leave out that dignu source, so I'll start again without that. It just looks like the usual configure make install. So yeah, configure prefix equals tools make and install. Okay, that's done. And we'll move on to tar. And once again, we can use the same sequence of commands to build tar. Okay, so that's tar completed. So one thing we can do now we've got a newer version of tar, is that I don't keep on, or it's not necessary to keep on specifying the J now. It automatically detects what the archive is. So for example, if I just do tar XVF now, it behaves as modern tars do. I said that, and it hasn't. I thought this was an updated one, and it clearly isn't. Okay, don't know why that is. I was certain that it was capable of doing that. So once again, I think I'm probably thinking of the LFS 6.3 recently completed. Okay, so we can once again do the usual three commands to build or configure build and install this package. Okay, that's text info done. So bash. Got a patch to put in first, and then looks like we can do the normal commands to build this, but we've got to remember to put the link in at the end when this is completed. Right, so that's completed 10 minutes. Just got to do this link. And that's done. So now move on to util Linux. So it looks like we just adjust the configure script, then we run it and we just build parts of util Linux for programs, just the programs that are needed. So I'll start with making the library. And then building mount and u mount. And we'll build more. Oops. That's done. So all we do now is copy those programs to the tools bin directory so that they're now in the path. Util Linux done, so move on to Perl now. Okay, so we put a patch in first after we've changed into the directory and make sure some static extensions get built. Configure it. Okay, so that has configured. Now we just build one part of Perl, the utilities. Again, it looks like we're just copying a small part after this bit has been built. Okay, so that has built. All we do now is just copy the programs and libraries into the tools hierarchy. And that's done, and that also completes all the programs that we need to build for the temporary LFS system. So let's tidy Perl up and move on to stripping. So this just strips debug symbols out of the code that we've compiled, which unlikely to need. If you do know that you would like to use that, or how to use it even, and obviously you wouldn't want to do this. And lastly, we can remove some documentation, including man pages. So that's it for the temporary system. We'll move next onto the building of the actual LFS system.